Hi, I'm John. I'm not a naturally lean guy. In fact, I was downright obese for many, many years. And when I found out that it wasn't my fault, well, that was one of the best days of my life. I'm going to tell you my story because it's probably very similar to your own. It doesn't matter if you're a guy or a gal, anyone who struggles with their weight and their waistline will relate to this story. And if you watch this entire video, which I promise you will not be online very long, I will do more than just tell you a story. I will give you the solution I discovered and used to this very day. Again, this video will not be up forever, so please watch it while you can. If you're anything like me, you've probably been beating your head against the wall for years, maybe even decades, all because you do not have that flat, firm stomach you long for. I remember the first time that I saw abs on someone. I was in the seventh grade. We were in the locker room after a football practice. Now, I knew my friend Joy had that body, you know, the one that girls loved and that the guys wanted to have, but I never knew he had that great abs. I mean, a firm, super tight midsection that just made me want to go home and do 1,000 sit-ups. And guess what? I did. I was really sore the next day. So sore I couldn't even practice. Now, you know the look of what I'm talking about. Hardly any fat around the waist. Great lines of tasteful muscle tone where most people carry those rolls of flab. And when Joey tucked in his shirt, nothing hung over his belt. Now, here's what struck me as very strange. Joey never did sit-ups. He never worked his abs at all in the gym, as a matter of fact. He was always working out, but I never once saw him do so much as even look at his abs. Now, many years later, as my stomach grew from a soft 33 inches to an obese 48 inches, I started remembering that first encounter with a fantastic set of abs. And you know what I did? I blamed it all on Joy's genetics. He was obviously born that way. That was the only answer. That's what I kept telling myself. Sure, Joey had great genetics. No one else in the locker room had those abs, that's for sure. But come on, I was lying to myself. Now, I'm an honest guy, so admitting this was very, very difficult. And the fact that I was lying to myself didn't hit me all of a sudden. After all, I'd tried dieting. I'd done sit-ups and crunches for years. The only thing I managed to do was pull my back muscles and trim my waistline by about an inch, maybe two at the most, but not an ab muscle in sight. My clothes were always uncomfortable on me, and I never wanted to take my shirt off at the beach or at the pool. In essence, I was like a prisoner in my own body. My mind wanted something, at least that I believed, my body could never give me. Maybe this sounds like someone that you know. Maybe it sounds just like you. Well, today I'm a different person. I sport a trim, firm stomach. And in fact, I saw my abs, all of them, for the first time at the age of 39. And you know what? They were better than Joey's abs. I was absolutely shocked. I mean, amazed. I was floored. Now, how did I do it? First, I embraced the one truth that hardly anyone knows or will tell you about getting lean abs. It's gonna blow your mind. Here it is. The best ab exercise in the world is no ab exercise. Now, that may come as a total shock to you. There is a time and place for ab exercises done correctly, for sure. But I saw the start of my abs before I ever did a crunch or ever did a leg raise, before I ever even thought about working my abs. Here's why this is the truth. If you train your abs directly too much, you're just gonna build the muscles underneath your layer of fat. Now that's great if you want a bigger stomach, and that's not what most of us want. Not only that, but direct ab exercises can cause your body to go into a state of what we call overtraining. This wears you out and makes you not want to go to the gym, not want to work out. It can even ruin your enthusiasm for dieting. Now, maybe you realize why you've started working out only to stop a few days or a few weeks later. I don't know, maybe you lasted a few months. I did. There's a better way to get the job done. and it's amazingly fast. Let me tell you another quick 30-second story about how some extra attention from women once you have lean ripped abs really is a nice payoff. I was out in a bar a couple of years ago with six or seven of my old college buddies, and most of them had let themselves get pretty out of shape in the recent years. And at one point, we started talking to a group of attractive young ladies and joking around with them, and out of nowhere, one of the hottest girls in the group comes up to me and says in a flirtatious voice, "Wow, you look like you're in pretty good shape. I want to see your abs." And then she literally yanked my shirt up and started running her hands over my abs. This made two or three of the other girls come over and check out the ab show too. And of course, this was a little embarrassing. And my college buddies were even more embarrassed because they didn't have the six